Mohawk International Welland facility. We're in the intermediate division round semifinal between the Throwbacks in the white jerseys with the orange shoulder caps. And the all red is the Vicious Alpacas. They represent the visitor bench. As it's worked up over center by the Throwbacks into the corner. Following well on it, you can see the pace has quickened. This will be our cap for our day this afternoon. The intermediate final. Moving on to the barn final. Oh, there's the winners. Taking up the London Barrels. Throwbacks trying to cut back here. Bring it out over center, Steve Gaskin. That shot goes in on Trevor Van Dyke. Pushed into the corner around Chad Asselton. Swiping for it, Craig Wood. It goes off the cage, comes back down for him. Pardon me, this is Trevor Van Dyke as the net comes off. Now right in front of Tyler McKinley. And the official will come back to reset the pegs. And the faceoff will come to the right of Van Dyke. Cal Kristoff, the Vicious Alpaca goaltender. Dredging in for the faceoff, Mark Vargas for the Alpacas. He plays it back for Dan Guthrie. From the point, the shot gets in. Van Dyke on the save. Bit of a shove there from Jesse Vargas, no harm. It goes in for Chad Asselton. He lifts it down the floor. It goes just to the side of Kristoff. And he goes for icing. We've got 1:40 gone. In the opening period. Waiting for a late change here from the Throwbacks. They do get final change. Apple occupying the other, the home bench. Face off played back for Chad Asselton. One more. Off the stick of Mackenzie McQueen there. Asselton rocks it up. Over center, first up, Justin Barbaro. Comes down on the half boards. Huge stick collision there. Mackenzie McQueen pinches down, takes over. Switching spots there with the ball carrier, Tyler McKinley. Got it, Barbaro couldn't hold around. Chad Asselton back chasing. The give and go there, 2-on-2. Justin Barbaro got beaten and quick step on Chad Asselton. I believe it was Jesse Bibas. Getting the pass away from Mike Schramm. 2-on-2 and got a step on both defenders. Quick goal here for the Vicious Alpacas. Just outside of the opening 2 minutes. They work the ball back into the corner. Played around again, they've got Van Dyke down. This goes back to the far half boards. Spinning the shot there was Barbas again. In front was Rich Brandt. Couldn't find the through to him for the tip. Trying to go up over center. Barbas plays it down for himself. Pardon me, Jesse Susan. He turns around, we see the 10. Turned over here now. Richard Manuel. Over center, Susie again, has Asselton with him, gets a quick shot away. Off the boards, it comes back and out. Susie through the middle, they call that just offside. As Rich Plant, a little too quick on that right wing. Matt Colletti was also in on this side, so they'll bring the face off out. Exactly 7 minutes to play. in our opening period. Faceoff walking in with a quick shot from Coletti. I knew that was Justin Dykstra as Dykstra gets it again on the wall, tries to spring Brian Lighton. Lighton down in the corner, now comes out in front of the throwback bench. Cycle back into the corner. Again for Garrett Russell. Russell gives chase for Lighton. They continue the cycle as Lighton looked to go in the net and couldn't get it past. The defender, Steve Gaskin, comes in the near wall, not to allow. Craig Wood. Now in front, Justin Dable. Just gets it away from his goaltender. Barber's giving chase. Goes in, circles the net here. Stopping that ball is Gaskin. Gaskin. Steele is calling for that. Pardon me, Brian McGahey. There's a shot from Mike Bardis on the near side, and both Bardises have a goal here. Where did Mike Schramm come in to tip that? Either way, it's a 2-1 lead. Early here for the Vicious Alpacas. 5.5 to play in just the first period. Face off one again by the Alpacas. It's back chipped ahead. Giving chase. Jesse Barbas. Barbas tries to spin away from Bernardo. Nice slide over there by Chad Hasselton. There's a ball chipped up and out of play. Tyler McKinley. Went off his stick, and I believe the trail official calls a tip. But they're still, and the lead official shrugs him off and says no, so they bring the faceoff outside. From here, it definitely looked like that went off the stick of McKinley. As McKinley comes in, got body contact the first time on Mike Barbas. This time they say he goes up way high. Barbas goes down holding kind of the nose or the eye. Both officials are going back and see if they saw anything. And Mike Barbas asked why there was no penalty. And he drew an unsportsmanlike penalty. Barbas will go to the bench and they'll put someone in the box though as Barbas continues to hold that injured eye. Face off to the right of Cal Kristoff. And it's going to ring all the way down the boards to the left of Van Gogh. Van Dyke, rather, pardon me. Brought up by Hasselton. Shot to the near half boards. Giving chase was Mackenzie McQueen, but the first man there was Justin Dable. Dable now meets two throwback defenders. And the throwbacks can't quite get there, and it's going to be Barbas. Jesse Barbas gets the first into the corner. Chad Hasselton comes in to help out Steve Gaskin, and this Gaskin is going to come away with it. There were three throwback jerseys. And the arm comes up, and Jesse Barbas Jesse Barbas picked up some kind of a penalty. And he's still arguing it, so. As Jesse Bargus picked up an unsportsmanlike penalty as well. Conversation continues at the faceoff dot with the second official, and a shot from outside by Asselton. Goes to the right of Kristoff, so. Maybe it was 10 for Bargus. As there's still four red jerseys on the floor. So 5-on-4 here for the throwbacks. And the jostle for battle position. He's coming up on that was Jesse Susie. Living on there from Chad Asselton, and they say no. As they are here for an interference call. Lifted down the floor, off the boards, into the corner. Throwbacks will bring it out from behind his own net. Shot from Asselton, comes in on Kristoff, goes a little high before. And I think another alpaca being sent to the box here. Three alpacas in the box. Four of them. And now they do take one of the red jerseys off as they make it 5-on-3. There's a shot. That one hits Kristoff high off the shoulder. And up into the cage. Off the shot from Chad Asselton. 3:58 and what's turning into a pretty crazy first period here. Penalty filled one for the Vicious Alpacas. Throwbacks, like we said, do get final change. And the barking is still coming from the penalty box. Whether that was picked up the second one. Comes back up for Asselton. He looks out of the way, took a bit of a bump there from Brian Wrighton. As they walk it backwards. Cast in front, Brian McGahey. Off the backboards, off the back of the stick of Kristoff, who ran low. And played back into the corner. McGahey again. He's trying to go for Matt DeLauer, who's in the corner. Asselton takes top position again. Here for him, he rips the shot. That goes off the blocker high. Over the cage and into the screen on pad two. Pad two currently sitting vacant as we fight for a spot. Again, in our intermediate final. Final semifinal here before we head for our rec division final. The Sarnia Beavers and the Broad Street Blazers coming up at the conclusion of this game. Game number two. Our five on our coverage here on the JBI Sports Network this afternoon. Play comes back up for the throwbacks. There was an early whistle, and I believe calling for the pass on the far side. I believe it's Travis Parkin over there. First penalty has expired. Still running, probably two in the box and four on the floor, so definitely at least one 10-minute misconduct. They're called against the Alpacas. So here comes McGahey, chaser after. Jumping out of the way, ball down the right to the floor. Handled by Van Dyke, up for Chad Asselton. Back for McGahey, chasing in. McGahey, up for Asselton, they continue to play catch here. On this near side, over to the far face off that, Parkin was there, couldn't get stick on it, drops down from McGahey, he's in front, and body out of midair, possibly with a high stick, no call as it comes back down, throwbacks touch it anyways. And we've got another calling for the pass up top, pardon me, there was a throwback player that was also sent to the box. Along with Jesse Bowden, so as the door opens, Steve Gaskin comes out, and that's why there was only four on the floor for the Alpacas, as it was offsetting minors. So now just the one penalty for the Alpacas. Presumably no 10-minute misconduct on that one. We'll wait and see what happens here, as there's 2:05 to go in the opening period. Steve Gaskin through the middle. He was trying to find, I believe, Tyler McKinley in the neutral zone, went around him. And 34 remains in this opening period. Again, first of 3 10-minutes that we play. If necessary, we'll go to overtime and a shootout. And shot off the stick of McKinley. May have hit a defender. That's what they're going to rule, as they'll send the face off to the right of Kyle Kristoff. So up high off the shed. And Will Platt looks behind him to see where the trailer is. He's got Jesse Soucy on the right wing. Soucy coming in, trying to chip it past Van Dyke. And it's controlled by McKinley, taken out. Final minute here. As they come over the line, Craig Wood. On the near side, Mackenzie McQueen winds and fires into the leg. McKinley, the second chance. Hits it in the middle. Stolen away there by the Alpacas, and now throwbacks have it again. Mackenzie McQueen into the legs of a defender. McQueen's going to take it himself as he got around Justin Dable. And we've got a hooking penalty called by the trail official, and I believe it's going to the Alpacas again. Bill Bunch was the one that was most upset about that call. And it is going to be Justin Dable going off. So the face off to the left of Cal Kristoff here. More penalty trouble for the Alpacas. That's been the story in this opening period. Chipped away and dumped down by Jesse Barbas. Giving chase, I believe, is Mike Barbas, who's back on after perhaps a high stick. There's a shot from the outside. Mark Croto goes in on Van Dyke, who smothered up. 8.6 left in the clock before we head to our first intermission. Face off now to the right of Trevor Van Dyke. Quick shot coming from up top, Mark Croto. It was up off the cage as Van Dyke went down, so we'll do the face-off again. Again to the right of Van Dyke. Barbas may have got a stick up high now. As Travis Parkin goes down, he's checking the notes. Clarifications for both benches during that brief intermission, but the throwbacks will have a power play here. They started with their first offensive possession. Asseltine stands up his man though. In an odd man rush, they go to the far side looking for Tyler McKinley. Jesse Barbas got things started off before Matt Barbas from the point. Finally, Mike Barbas got it in behind Trevor Van Dyke for a 2-0 lead after one. Cal Kristoff, maybe that one was a little loose, bouncing around as the officials will change the ball here. Throwbacks looking to capitalize here. Chipped around to Mike Schramm coming in, and Trevor Van Dyke came all the way out of the cage. This one's going to go high. Nearly takes out our camera way up there. Gary Morrison, our producer and camera operator today. along with our director, Ryan Harkness. I'm Matthew Carrick. That's our JV on Sports Network crew this afternoon. Van Dyke settles in, watches another face-off to his right side. Chad Asseltine up for Travis Parkin. Parkin lifts one from his own blue line, and going down is Kristoff. Covers up and he'll hang on for the face-off to his right. Parkin motioning the knuckleball action the ball's taking here today. No wind. Very hot conditions. Mercury up around 35 plus at times here this afternoon in Welland. Into the corner. McKinley and I believe Craig Wood tag teaming to steal that away from Ryan Wrighton. That's going to be brought over center by Steve Gaskin. There's a shot in, Coletti makes the save, and maybe Wrighton got the stick in on the ankle or the shin guard. Wrighton joins the rush now as limping off is McKinley. Over in the corner, there's a shot by Justin Dykstra, and Van Dyke not sure where it was, it went wide. Here comes all the way up top. Huge blast from Dan Guthrow. Right off the faceoff, dot spinning, it's just over top of Van Dyke. Wrighton through the crease. Maybe took a bit of a whack from Van Dyke. Wrighton jostling in there with Craig Wood now. Wood gets it all the way up top. Here's Guthrow again, stepping in off the point now. Takes the shot, tipped by Wrighton, it goes wild. Here it comes for Paskin. The trailer is not Delisle. Delisle's got McGahey with him. McGahey tried to pass it over here. The shot was tipped away. Breaks down into the corner. And the official's arm goes high as Adam Fortin, I believe, is getting called for a hold. The Alpacas are arguing that their guy is high-sticked on the way down. I think most of the argument is that that penalty wasn't called. I'm not sure that there was any argument on the holding call for Adam Fortin, and now the barking returns from the bench as the official goes back to the timekeeper's box. Face off to the right of Kristoff. Like the floor, Chad Asseltine. And Brian McGahey. They pick him, calling for the pass as the stick went high. And it was a trail official making that call. The best hat on the floor today. 7:22 remains in the middle frame here this afternoon. Once again, the intermediate division, the semifinal. In the corner, Craig Wood got the corner on his man. Now it's up for Richard Monroe. McGahey gets it back again. And we've got off-center manners here now. Headed back to the box is Jesse Soucy, along with Richard Monroe. And both of them say they did nothing. But the official, with the chirping going on and the upset for the officials here, they're obviously trying to keep a cap on things as the conversation takes its way out into the penalty box. Those two are off-center manners. So it'll still be a power play for the throwbacks, 5-on-4. And this time it's gloved out of midair by Van Dyke. Forecheck was coming, so it'll be chipped away by Travis Parkin. Another glove saved by Van Dyke. This time they've got a man right on him, Rich Plant. Plant may have got some stick action on Van Dyke. parking. Back for Chad Asaton. Fakes a couple shots and didn't miss high by that much. Although it did go up over top of Kristoff. Near side parking, we'll have McGahee in front. He can't get stick on it to tip that for the redirect. Comes up for Chris Williams. Williams slaps it up for Chad Asaton. Is that stolen away? Near side parking. McGahee again, the trail streaking in. Dying seconds of the power play, 6:13. They're calling for him to run up the near boards. Justin Bernardo.
I got you.
Bernardo giving chase. Into the corner, it comes back to the point. Travis Parkin. Chad Asaton lets one loose. And again, he's got Mike Barbas up with him, so he can't release. Justin Bernardo's got to take up. Goes for Chad Asaton, keeps it in. That shot goes wide. McKenzie McQueen chases to the half boards. Up for Asaton again. Rolls on him a little bit. Back for McQueen. That's one rip, and they have Parkin in front. So Kristoff will just hang on. And the faceoff will come to his left. 5:38 to go on the clock. Ball lifted all the way up to center. Mark Schramm is giving chase and went up over top of Craig Wood. And now we continue the battle for it. Mike Barbas, it goes off the glove of Wood. Back down for McKinley. McKinley takes up post in front of the net. Swinging a shot there. Jesse Barbas looking for his second of the game. In much the same fashion as he's out of the box. Back to 5-on-5. The stick of Brendan Crosby was tied up, so he couldn't bail that one home. The net, side of the net was open. Mackenzie McQueen. Here's a shot. That one coming from outside from McKinley. I believe that hit his own man streaking out in front. Brendan Crosby, maybe. Down the far side, Steve Gaskin. There's some jostling inbound. The play officials will let that one go as they converse. Around the half boards. Here comes Steve Gaskin, and that shot may have hit the pipe. In behind Kristoff. Bunch of tiring bodies as we're into the second half of this game. Still just the two opening period goals by the Barbas clan. Jesse and Mike. In that opening period. After penalty trouble for the Vicious Alpacas. Again, the Alpacas in the red. White and orange for the Throwbacks. Face off to the right of Kristoff. Comes up to the point. There's a shot from Gaskin. It goes high off the cage and then up and over. To bring the face off outside the zone. 4:29 on the clock now. Off now to the left of Kristoff. Stays on the floor for a while before that shot from Steve Gaskin. Pinballs out around. Took a funny turn in midair as Gaskin now has to chase. It comes way back. Craig Wood rifles a shot. It goes off the backboards. Players complaining about this ball. Maybe a little small. Hard as a rock, they say. Play continues though. Craig Wood. Collision right in front of us is Terry Smith. I think he went down. He gets up in time to give chase here. In behind Kristoff, but winning that foot race, Justin Deirdre. Deirdre has it now. Off the boards, it comes up for Wrighton. Wrighton plays it back for Deirdre. Rolls away from him. He's got Dan Guthrow on his wing. Up through the middle. A nifty pass there between the legs. Garrett Russell gets it to his winger. Sneaking down his right, and he just misses the right pad side of Van Dyke. Over to the far wing. Here comes Matt Delisle. In front, someone's lost the stick as it bounds off the boards and in behind Van Dyke. It goes for icing. Official checking that ball. Looks like he's coming over the time box. Well, I think they will, in fact, they are switching the ball anyways here today because of the heat, keeping the balls on ice to keep them hard. That one a little too much. Here comes Wrighton. Wrighton stick carrying through, almost falls, gets in on Van Dyke. And the poke check from Van Dyke. Pushed it aside. Parkin. He goes to the far wing, not Delisle though. Delisle lost it as Wrighton stepped up Chad Asselton. He thought he ran into him. But again, no call coming. Comes through middle, Jesse Searcy. There's a whistle here, maybe offside, or and someone called for a pass. And the officials do confirm it is the offside call. So bring the face off outside the zone. Sticks play in for it, Mark Coletti. Lower Molly comes through for Travis Parkin. Tried to work up the middle, stolen away. Jesse Searcy now. Susie's got Rich Plant with him. Just dumps it into the corner. Where Searcy is. Spinning in the shot. As it works to the far side. Stick hand over there is Matt Delisle. Dumped into the corner and it goes for icing. This heat now is some of the fans starting to come in. We've had to move positions and can see a couple bubbles starting to form in the floor, a huge one right in front of the entrance door where the players come in. We'll see if those come into play as this day progresses and the day continues to get hot just inside the 1 o'clock hour. Here in Welland, turning away Chris Williams, turns it over, then Mackenzie McCoy is there. Williams gets it out of harm's way to the far corner, but will not foot race into the corner. Tyler McKinley. McKinley over the blue line, comes right in front of us again. Craig Wood is there. Wood has to back pedal, right on top of that bubble we talked about, in front of his own bench. McKinley lets one fly. Pinching off his wood. He's got McKinley McQueen spinning and firing as McKinley pinched in. Pardon me, that was Brendan Crosby in front of the net. 3-on-2 as Jesse Searcy starts a rush. Searcy slips over there. And that's going to hand it over here for Steve Gaskin. Gaskin cycles back for McKinley. Mackenzie McQueen drops low to keep that play in. Over for Craig Wood. Wood looking down in the corner. Gaskin now comes over, Adam Fortin in there for the Alpacas. Jesse Searcy loves it down to himself. Him and McKinley are tied up. And it's going to be the throwbacks that come away with it. Brendan Crosby into the corner. McKinley slides up the boards. In front for Crosby again. Crosby's got to chase it back into the corner one more time. Still with Fortin on him. Tries the other side and this one up. Over Mackenzie McQueen. Van Dyke out of his net brings it up the near side on the stick of Craig Wood. Wood's going to take it himself past the faceoff guy. It was into the feet. Of Chris Garrett, and it got turned over for the shot from Jesse Bowness. Went wide on Van Dyke. Over on the half board, Steve Gaskin. Tries to go up through the middle. It passes every much side. one more time. So Trevor Van Dyke takes up the net to our left. As Chad Austin starts shot sails and goes up over Cal Kristoff, who is now on the net to the right. Vicious Alpacas in the red on the visitors bench. Throwbacks in the white and orange on the home bench, trailing 2-0 at this point. Coming up next, players starting to take their places for the rec final. Coming up at 2, Bradstreet Blazers will play their first game of the afternoon as they win their semifinal by forfeit. Sarnia Beavers had to play their way in. Dan Guthrie stands up his man at the point. Now we've got a stick battle in front of us between Chad Asseltine and Mike Schramm. Schramm fouls. She turns the ball over. Terry Smith steps in her shot. Looks like it went off the hand of the Alpaca defender. So Schramm goes to the far side. Jesse Barbas into the corner for Schramm again. Mike Barbas has it way away from him, so throwbacks will pick up and come up the near side. Chris Garrett trying to wrap check was Jesse Barbas. She goes to the far side to where Steve Gaskin is. He lets fire on rip. And Kristoff goes down. Up the near side, Garrett Russell. The Alpaca is trying to quip this one and it goes in. Rolled away from Van Dyke. He had a man in tight that couldn't switch hands quick enough. Here comes Travis Parkin. Came racing off the bench as that ball was loose. And Kristoff had to go away to make a quick save. Far side for Whiten. Alpacas had to hold up as they were being called for offside. So it goes for Brian McGahee. Stolen over. Here's Garrett Russell. Again with numbers. Up into the glove of Gaskin. Steve Gaskin up over center with throwbacks of a 5-on-2 of their own. There's Parkin. That's one rip, and that's off the body of Chris Williams, who backed his way through the middle. The official trying to fix that bubble. It's actually just moved further in. And just the heat wreaking havoc on the floor here. Trail official says it went off the throwbacks player. 7:39 to go in the third period, regulation time here. As they bring the face-off outside the blue line. The Alpacas give it to the official as he throws the ball into their own bench. But play is whistled in and the Alpacas win the face-off, but ball chipped off a stick. Parkin got there. Comes over and out for the Alpacas. Back on the blue line, Dable over for Wright. He gains the zone. Back for Garrett Russell. Russell's got McGahee on him. And it's a turnover. Comes over for Parkin. 3-on-2 now for the throwbacks. As Parkin steps in, gets it off the leg of the defender. And Matt Delisle can't get it to settle. Goes into the corner for Delisle. Chris Williams behind his own net. Tried to get it out. Tyler McKinley, a nice pinch down the boards. Comes back for Williams again. Switches direction over for Wrighton. Wrighton and McKinley, pardon me, and Williams are low. As Wrighton chips around Parkin. And now it's back behind the throwback. Matt Alpacas take the chance to change up. McKinley backs his way into the defender, streaking through the middle. There's a quick shot from Steve Gaskin. It gets it on Kristoff. Lift it up off the boards in front of the throwback's net, and it'll go for icing against the Alpacas, who just wanted to relieve pressure there on that play, 6-19. Again, this game 2 of 5 here on the afternoon at Barnes Semifinal. We saw the winners defeat the London Direwolves. They'll move on to the Barnes Semi. The Rec Final comes up next at 2 o'clock. They'll be signing the Beavers and the Broad Street Blazers. Coming up in approximately 6 minutes and 11 seconds to play. Face-off to the right of Kristoff. Quick shot off the face-off. One there by Brandon Crosby. Aceton settles it down, and Susie ends up falling. Justin Bernardo got it over for Aceton. He dumped it in. Susie's in behind. But they can't find him as Mackenzie McQueen brings it over to the face-off. Chipped it in. Couldn't get through to Kristoff, though. Bernardo up for Aceton. His shot goes wide. Brandon Crosby. Stick knocked out of his hands. Goes down low. Out of the way of Aceton. So he's got a retreat. Susie follows him. Up for Mackenzie McQueen. Here's a shot off the shin guard of Guthrow. Into the corner. Comes up for McKinley again. McKinley at the blue line. Bernardo does hold the red line. As McQueen. Trying to get around Guthrow. Got backhands it into the corner. McKinley's there. McKinley from the top of the circle takes the shot. That goes off the body of Mike Croto, who's in front. McQueen back behind the net. And Kristoff went down. There's a jousting match in front. Mackenzie McQueen's involved. And the official blew the whistle. And not sure if he's sending anybody off here, but anyway, Kristoff called for water here. Mackenzie McQueen keeps chirping. So McQueen definitely going off. As is Mike Croto now. McQueen will take their differences to the box. And the Alpaca bench trying to settle their team down here. Offsetting penalties, but what this does, it takes Mackenzie McQueen off the floor for the throwbacks. Strong defender who can pinch in and provide offense. They need it now. Trailing 2-1. 2-0 rather, after those opening period, 2 goals. Follow on the play was Jesse Barbas. Gets up with a stare down. Oh, on the far side, Travis Parkin. He got the blade of the stick too high, and as the one time that came through, it did go in and out. But taken off the board as they really called for the pass. .32 to play now. Ball goes outside the zone. Here's McGahey, soft 5-hole, let it rip, and closed quickly round by Kristoff. Cal Kristoff will hang on, still just 2-0. We're in the third period, 4:25 to go. The only game ongoing in the tournament is pad 2 sits silent. Trying to trip it through the middle, all over that with Steve Gaskin as he rushes in into the corner for McGahey. McGahey takes a shot, and again, 5-hole is open, the stick comes down from Kristoff to close it up. Mike Barbas has one already, he's through the middle. Working in top corner, what a shot, right by us. Right when the throwbacks needed one. Stoller turns into a 2-on-1 and Mike Barbas comes down the near side and picks top corner. 2-on-1 played beautifully by the defender, making sure that pass didn't go through. But just on the stick side, perhaps Van Dyke a little too far left. Faceoff battled for before being battled back by Garrett Russell. Comes near side by Chris Garrett. Just out of the reach of Richard Monroe. Monroe. Now goes back to work on Garrett Russell. Russell behind his own net, 3.5 to play. So working in the corner, that's caught in the feet of the official. Back for Russell again. Russell lifts it up. Well, his defense goes over to touch it, Craig Wood negates the icing. Far side, McKinley. Out of his reach there, and streaking down is Wrighton. Van Dyke's just going to kick it over the corner. Ryan Wrighton gets there first. Tyler McKinley for the throwbacks comes over. Now he gets help as Susie came in. Wrighton still with it. Drawing the double team. Wrighton's going to get away with that and then back into the corner. Great job by Brian Wrighton in behind as he controlled the play for about 20 seconds back there. Jesse Susie was after this, trying to stick handle away, trying to clear Wrighton out from in front of the net. And finally, the throwbacks do get it. They get it up through center. Slow and a stick in disgust, though, Chris Garrett. As the throwbacks take the chance to change, Chad Asselton back on the floor. He gets it up for Garrett. Garrett goes around Rich Plant. Far side for Parkin. Parkin in front of McGee. Stick down here looking. Top corner, glove side. Asselton gets it back to the front and they can't get stick on it again. McGee. There's a shot and out for Parkin. Side was open. They do call a goal as Parkin snuck in. Kind of got the sense it was a little matter of time before Travis Parkin was going to score here this afternoon. So he's been all over the ball. But that one makes it 3-1. Maybe if that Barbas goal doesn't happen, it's got a different story. But a 2-goal deficit here for the throwbacks. Got to put the pedal down here. Off-center man, it's all over. As the face-off goes back for Asselton, he chips it to the far side. Parkin was winding up and got into the feet of the Alpaca player. Don't have a name or a number for 84 as he was late coming through. Tyler Van Dyke to the bench, took a head-first dive to make sure he got off. He was directing traffic as he got there too. Quick shot by Mackenzie McQueen. Kristoff is down, makes the save. Minute 40 on the clock as McGinley takes over. McQueen low again. He's on day ball. Here's McGahee. Parkin up for Asselton. His quick shot finds glove. And Kristoff is there. He was looking for the tip. I think Asselton was. As McQueen was down low. Minute 27. We look to the bench. And Trevor Van Dyke. Looks like he's going to stay. There's no timeout as of yet. There's McGahee to the faceoff dot. He's got Mackenzie McQueen with him. McQueen's got a chase now. Over the far side by Parkin. Comes over to help out. Asselton on the back check and they can't get it away from Mike Schramm. Schramm makes it 4-1, minute 17. And that may do it. We'll see. And indeed, Van Dyke is coming back and heads hanging low for the throwbacks here. As the Vicious Alpacas may be headed to the intermediate semifinal. here at the JumpStart Jammer. BHi Welland facility. Face off one back. Played for by Steve Gaskin. Played deep off the boards. It comes up. Throwbacks had to come touch up, as they do just in time for Brendan Crosby to get back to the line. McQueen, they've got a stick on that as we enter the final minute. 59.7 on the clock as it goes up high and out. Faceoff will come outside the zone. Throwbacks looking for three goals in the final minute here, the empty netter. From Mike Schramm. The man of the day has been Mike Barbas. Second and third goals. Second one of beauty. He's got the ball now. Chips it up the far side. Looking for Jesse Barbas, and he just couldn't get stick on it. So here comes Mike Schramm. They want it all the way back in their zone. It does end up on the stick of Adam Fortin, who continues to back pedal all the way down behind their own net now. Mike Barbas, 25 seconds on the clock. Triangle tries to close down. Barbas just going to back away. Schramm back down the corner. Adam Fortin in there. Conserve energy, keep it away from the throwbacks, and let this final 12 seconds expire here. Throwbacks not in any hurry to go in forechecks, and they'll just leave it in the corner.